Yeah, I'm building my own dynasty. It just goes one tweet at a time, brick by brick by brick. There's a tendency to assume that Donald Trump will be gone from national politics sometime in the next five-ish years. After all, either he loses in November 2020, or he leaves office in January 2025 after serving his constitutionally limited two terms. And sure, he jokes about staying in office beyond 8 years, but he's joking, right? Right? Even if Trump is joking, and honestly, who really can say, there's every reason to believe that the idea he and his brood will disappear from the political world anytime in the next decade is totally and completely, well, in a word, wrong. In fact, if the past 3 years of President Donald Trump has taught us anything, it's that this is a man and a family who loves, loves, loves the spotlight and has roughly zero interest in stepping away from it anytime soon. Quote, "The Trumps will be a dynasty that lasts for decades," predicted none other than Trump 2020 campaign manager Brad Parscale in a speech at the California Republican Convention in 2019. Now, if you take a step back, it makes all the sense in the world that when Trump leaves office, he will look to his own family, likely either his eldest daughter Ivanka or his eldest son and namesake Don Jr., to hand off his political brand. Right? Right. Right. Long before he got into politics, Trump's inner circle has largely been limited to his family, with a few longtime sycophants sort of sprinkled into the mix. All three of his eldest children, Don Jr., Ivanka, and Eric, were employed in the family business. Don Jr. and Eric Trump now run the Trump Organization, with their father residing in the White House. And all three were also featured in his various reality TV projects, often literally at the right hand of their father. Quote, "They're undeniably adaptable," Kellyanne Conway, a senior counselor to the president, told The Atlantic of the president's children in 2019, and she added this, "When the family business was real estate, they learned contracts and building approvals and architecture. Then it was television, and they learned that industry. Now, a decade later, they've turned around and learned politics," end quote. And Trump himself has made no secret since coming into the White House of how he views his children and their, in his mind, unlimited capabilities. Of Ivanka, the president told The Atlantic in 2019, quote, "If she ever wanted to run for president, I think she'd be very, very hard to beat." He then added this, quote, "She went into the whole helping people with jobs, and I wasn't sure that was going to be the best use of her time. But I didn't know how successful she'd be. She's created millions of jobs, and I had no idea she'd be that successful," end quote. Oh yeah, the whole helping people with jobs thing, of course. How, you ask, has Ivanka Trump created millions of jobs? The president didn't really go into that. As for Don Jr., the president has expressed his shock and admiration for the sort of loyalty his eldest son engenders on the campaign trail as a surrogate for Republican candidates all over this country. Quote, "Don's gotten really good," Trump said while watching his son on Fox News, of course, in 2018. That's according to an unnamed source in the Washington Post. Trump went on to add, "My people love him," end quote, "my people." In 2018, Don Jr. wound up doing more than 60 events across the country for Republican candidates, according to the New York Times, for candidates that range from West Virginia to North Dakota and back. He was literally everywhere. And his success seems to be the result of a son taking on the personality of the father and then some. If Donald Trump occasionally crosses the line of unacceptable or non-presidential behavior, Don Jr. has made stepping over the line his brand, sharing edgy memes that border on outright racist at times and reveling in his status as the most hated Trump sibling. Quote, "He's one of the bros," Mike Cernovich, a prominent conservative social media persona, said of Trump Jr., and he went on to add this, "He has a classically masculine personality, and you don't feel like he's a snob. He really likes the meme culture. It's not fake for him," end quote. Really likes the meme culture. Hope that's my epitaph. And Don Jr. hasn't been shy at all about his interest in following in his father's political footsteps. Quote, "I definitely enjoy the fight," he told Bloomberg News in 2019, adding, "I definitely like being out there, and I love being able to see the impact and the difference that it makes on these people's lives that I get to see all over the country." And when it came to his age and when he might run, Donald Trump Jr. had this to say, "We have a lot of time. My father decided to get into politics at 68. I'm 41. I've got plenty of time," end quote. Here's the thing. If Don Jr. or Ivanka Trump ran in 2024, they would be real contenders because, well, their last name is Trump. For voters looking for the rightful heir to the Trump presidency, and there will be lots and lots of those people within the Republican Party, what better way to hand off the Trump baton than to one of his blood relatives? And do you really think, knowing what we know about Trump's reliance on his family, that he wouldn't rather hand his legacy off to one of his children rather than, say, his current vice president? Sorry, Mike Pence. All signs then point to this simple conclusion. Donald Trump and his family aren't going anywhere anytime soon. And that is the point. We make New Point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday, and now we've added a special third episode every weekend. I hope you check them all out.